Hi guys, I'm Marticore, and I'm just letting you know that there are plenty of essential bugs in The Sims 2 that you might not even know about. So today I'll show you mods that fix things that aren't coded properly. Most of them were broken through patches, so I am making this video in the context of the Ultimate Collection. If you lack some expansions, if you have the Super Collection on Mac, you might not experience these glitches in your game. And I won't be covering simple stuff like the shadow fix, the anti-corruption mods, or the broken face template fix that you fellas probably know about already because you're definitely simmers of culture. I deeply believe that. I wanna talk about stuff that you might think of as a feature when it's really not and it should be fixed. Let's go! Did you know that some additional skills that came with apartment life don't work properly? Especially physiology and fire safety. Learning physiology will make your sim hit level 10 of body in just a few seconds whenever they do anything sporty. You probably noticed it in your game and didn't know where it came from. Well, here's the answer. Sims should build the skill faster, but not this fast. And fire safety is pretty much useless. In theory, Sims are supposed to act more professionally when there's a fire, so, you know, not shout at it and just burn to death, but actually try to extinguish it or whatever, but learning this skill doesn't actually do anything. So there are fixes for those two things. We're saved. Another thing that might be annoying is the exercise bike. Not only do Sims get obsessed with the bike, but they will never get off it. Never. It's a pretty rare occurrence, but when left unsupervised, Sims can go all day and just die of starvation. Trust me, it happens. So this fix doesn't stop the Sims' obsession about going on the bike, but they will get off it when their needs are low. So at least it's not deadly. Lifetime wants are cool and all, but Sims never have the wants about careers that require a university degree. So this mod unlocks those wants and your Sims can finally want to become a cult leader, ecological guru, icon, or visionary. Since free time, there's also this thing that you can't call NPCs anymore. NPCs meaning not Mrs. Crumplebottom or whatever, like the ones that can break your game literally, but the simple ones such as the maid, the mail and newspaper carriers, and all those Sims that you might want to be friends with or just anything, or like marry them. But since you can't call them anymore, it's kind of difficult to do that. So Sijon, who is the author of millions of fixes for The Sims 2, made a mod for that. But do remember that you need Smarter EP check if you have any of Sijon's mods, especially the newer ones. If you don't have that little file, your game may glitch out a little bit in some situations. So just remember to have that in your game, okay? The Smart Milk used to work properly, but it doesn't anymore. Now, it never stops being active. It never wears off. If you give your toddler the Smart Milk once, they will learn skills a lot faster, at least up until they're teenagers. This way, the game becomes less of a challenge, and you can end up with Sims who maxed out a skill when they were still toddlers. And not everyone is Mozart. That's just not right, and fortunately, there's a fix for that. It makes the Smart Milk work like it used to in the base game. Once the glow disappears, so does the skill boost. I know that Smart Milk isn't necessarily something that people use all the time, but it's good to know that it is in fact broken. The engagement memory glitches out sometimes so that non-romance Sims get a negative memory of getting engaged, but then a positive memory of getting married. Some people try to read some storytelling into it, but it is just a simple bug that can, of course, be fixed with a mod. And here's a video from Pleasant Sims on how to change the memory in SimPE to green when you already had that glitch happen. And you care about memories, you know. If you ever play with alien-human mixes, or just Sims created using the debug mode that have the alien eyes but non-alien skin, their eyes will turn brown when they're teenagers. Specifically teenagers. And it's not really exactly brown, it's an empty color that you can get if you, for example, delete custom eyes that your sim had. Genetically, they have black eyes, but they just appear brown. There's a mod called Creature Fixes that takes care of this issue and many more. And, very important note right now, if this mod doesn't work for you, which is very likely, just change its name, adding an underscore at the beginning, like this, so that it loads first. It wasn't working for me either, and this method fixed it. I'm telling you that because it's extremely common with this specific mod. This can also fix other mods that might not work for you. And for the black eyes to reappear, you need to change the sim's appearance in the mirror to refresh their looks. You don't need to actually edit anything, just click OK and the eyes should be back. Another thing that has a broken code is the cold. Your sims have about 1% chance to come back from work sick, and technically, when not treated, cold should turn into pneumonia after some time. But guess what? It never does. Instead, the game ends up just killing your sim. It shouldn't be possible for them to die from a cold, but it actually is. The only mod I can think of that fixes that is the disease mod, that also changes other things about sickness and makes it a little bit trickier. But it brings back pneumonia into the game and stops sims from dying of a cold, so maybe it's worth it. Especially that it doesn't really take illness to an extreme level, like the real sickness mod. It's just a bit harder for sims to get better, and to me, it actually makes more sense. Aren't you tired of grandma constantly trying to sleep in her grandchild's room? Yeah, I thought so. Technically, there is a code that should make sims remember their beds, but similarly to the cold, it's a mess and doesn't work. So there's a mod called Smart Beds that makes sims actually remember where they sleep, even their side of a double bed. Kind of like in The Sims 4. It goes to a point where if you tell your sim to go to sleep in another bed by mistake, they will go to their bed anyway. But sometimes you need to reset the bed ownership because sims freeze if somehow another sim sleeps on their side of a double bed, but it's not really that big of a problem. Overall, the mod is great. I can't really play without it right now. I can't imagine sims being just all over the place with the bed ownership. With apartment life, there's this cool feature of aging up townies when your active sim is having birthday. You can age up townies of the same age that this sim knows. But if you ever age up children this way, they will never get an aspiration as teens. Some simmers think the lack of aspiration is a sign of corruption. Nothing like that. The devs just forgot to code that. Really. And since this is an overlook, obviously someone made a fix for that. This mod The Sims upload also has other birthday-related fixes, so I recommend having a look. The same guy who made the aging mods and a lot of different fixes made a fix for pizza. Yes, pizza. This is a very recent revelation for me. I had no idea, but it turns out that there are two types of pizza in the game that are supposed to be chosen randomly once you order one. But we already know very well that random results are almost never random in The Sims 2, so this is broken as well. So if you're a pizza fan and you want to have a little bit more variety in this matter, get that little fix. And that's all! I wanted this to be not only a mods showcase, but also a trivia video. I'm pretty sure you didn't know about at least one of those issues. If you can think of something else that fixes things that are obviously game glitches, let us know in the comments. But if it's more about annoying game mechanics than actual code overlooks, wait for another video I'm going to make very soon. It'll be exactly about that. Fixes for little annoyances. Of course, links to all the mods are in the description below, and as always, thank you very much for watching. Subscribe, like the video, and see you in the next one. Bye!